And welcome back. We all know Pete Davidson from his 7 seasons on Saturday Night Live, but few people know a person like your family does.
That is for sure. This week I had a chance to chat with Pete and his grandfather, Stephen. We talked about their bond, Pete's childhood, and a new way they're helping others stay connected.
This is my new dog, Locke.
Locke?
Locke.
L-O-C-K?
L-O-C-K-E. Aww. I got locked this week. So
just this week.
Yeah, and I'm allergic to all dogs, even like hypoallergenic ones. But for some reason, I'm not allergic to her. I'm really, really lucky. So I guess 2020 ended okay.
New puppy aside, it's been a big year for 27-year-old Pete Davidson from a Netflix comedy special.
No, it's like any other breakup. You have your boys over, they all lie to you, you know? They're like, dude, no problem, bro. Nobody even knows who she is.
To a critically acclaimed movie based partly on his own life. And, of course, his 7th season on Saturday Night Live.
Pete Davidson!
How's this year been for you guys, doing the show?
First off, I'm just like very lucky and just like relieved that I have any work to go to. They've made everything so safe. Everybody gets tested every day. Lauren and all the cast and everybody, we're just happy that they figured out a way for us to still do it during these times.
But for his latest collaboration, he has just one special co-star.
Alexa, drop in on Pete Davidson.
His grandfather, Stephen. So awesome to have your grandfather here. What do you call him? Do I call you Stephen? Do I call you, what do you call him, Pete?
Call me Poppy.
I call him Stephen Davidson. No, I call him Poppy.
I babysat for Pete. We used to make movies all the time, and he'd do stunts. You can't believe some of the stunts he did without a stuntman.
I could.
Oh, yes.
My favorite thing was, like, he loved making movies so much, he would let me do pretty much whatever. Like, he would let me, like, jump off of his shed.
That bond over movies came full circle this summer when Pete gave Poppy a cameo in his movie, The King of Staten Island.
It's all a scam.
I was getting really jealous on set because, like, everybody kept coming up to me being like, your grandfather's hilarious. And I was just like, yeah, but like, I'm good too, right?
Let's talk about this partnership and donation that you're announcing with us today.
As much as I'd love to be with Poppy over the holidays, it's just not happening in 2020. So we teamed up with Amazon to show how anyone, even older people, can stay connected with family and friends.
Through the partnership, Amazon is donating $1 million worth of devices to organizations that help people near and dear to Pete's family, frontline workers, and first responders. Pete's dad and Stephen's son, Scott Davidson, was a New York City firefighter who died on September 11th. Poppy, what can you say about your son? What can you say about Scott, his fellow firefighters, and really what it means to you to give back?
Well, what it means to me is they really are heroes. You know, the word hero is used very loosely, but these guys really were. These guys deserve it all.
One of the organizations they're helping is named Answer the Call.
Without Answer the Call, me and my family wouldn't have been able to get through my adolescence.
What are your memories of that time, and how did they support you? What did they do?
My mom and my sister, my mom is a single parent, and she had 2-3 jobs, and especially around the holidays, there's just certain things we wouldn't have been able to do without the support of them.
How proud are you, Poppy, of Mr. Pete here?
I could not be any prouder. I really do. I love
Pete. How awesome is that, man?
It's the best.
You're making us feel better. You're making us laugh. You know, you've been very open, about mental health challenges and your struggles. What do you do for yourself, especially when times are challenging, frankly?
For me, this year, just doing Christmas with, my mom and sister, and just really being appreciative. And this was just such a crazy year.
Poppy, I'm going to leave you with the last word. What do you want people to know about Pete? And 2, what are you looking forward to this holiday season?
Well, 1, Pete has tremendous generosity. Believe me when I tell you. And the other thing, what I wish for, it's for everybody. A healthy new year, and everybody be well. Can't think of anything else better than that for everybody.
picture. Look at this picture there. And after our interview, first of all, we had some other things that we were chuckling about for another day. But the whole crew, after it was over, I just want you guys to know, we stopped and we all just talked about how great it was to see Pete with his grandpa. You guys know I have a soft spot for my grandparents, you know, and I miss my grandparents. And you can't take that relationship for granted. And also, you know, another sidebar to this story, you know, I talk a lot about, you know, I do the series Through Mom's Eyes, where I talk about, you know, kids' upbringing and what have you. It was very clear to me, you know, Pete may have been kind of out there as a kid jumping off a shed and all that, but his grandfather affirmed him. They were making movies together, you know, and look what he's doing now. So I always think, you know, parents out there, sometimes your kids are just driving you nuts, but let's try.
They get there.
Right? They get there. And he's coming into his own. Absolutely. Absolutely. So I really enjoyed that interview. We should mention the King of Staten Island and Saturday Night Live, of course, both come from our sister companies that, along with NBC News, are all part of NBC Universal.
They are?
Yes, they are.
Oh, my gosh.
Have to get that in there.
I never knew.